Good evening, y'all. It is Reedy here. Today we are in Manila and we are searching for a little piece of America in the city. Today we're going to the Filling Station, which is an American-themed retro-style cafe and bar located in Poblacion in Manila. We got a little bit of a drive here, but I'm very excited. As a fellow American, I have not had a proper cheeseburger in months while I've been here in Asia since May, so today I'm very excited. It's time to fill up on some good grub, some drinks, and have a nice dinner here in Manila. Let's go. Alright, y'all, we have just arrived to the filling station, and guys, this place is so cool. They did an amazing job making this feel like an old school diner. All the decorations, the neon lights, the checkered floors, the chrome everything, old school cars. They even have a whole wall dedicated to Marilyn Monroe. They have old school cartoons like Popeye playing in the back. This place is very cool to say the least. Now, it's time to see, did they do a good job making American food here in the Philippines? All right, y'all, so we ordered a bunch of American classics here, especially since May has not tried some of them, so we're giving them a test. First on the list is an order of classic buffalo wings, so let's see how the filling station's wings are here. First, we're going to bite. No blue cheese or ranch. I don't actually know what's with it, but we're going first bite raw here. Those are pretty good. They're pretty good. I won't give them an A though. I maybe give them a C plus, B minus on that. I don't know how to rate it. They're not crispy enough, to be honest, but they're not so bad. Now, to make up for the average wings, we actually already got our food. One thing that they do in a very good American style is get you your food fast here, which in other parts of the world is very much not the case. So myself, I got a bacon cheeseburger, May got the shrimp po' boy, and to share, we got this monstrous root beer float here. This is the first time May has ever gotten a root beer float though, so we are gonna give, because I'm a gentleman, we are gonna give her the first sip and get her review on how an authentic root beer float is.
It's, do you think?
Yeah.
It's good?
Yeah. Look at that.
It's fine, I guess. I don't know.
All right, maybe she's not as big of a fan. I love these things, so to each his own, I guess. Guys, this is the moment of truth. We got their original bacon cheeseburger here. As you can see, in American style, though. This is a big, thick boy. Nice bit of lettuce and tomato. Let's give this a shot. Wow, this is good, nice and crispy. Ordered a medium rare, so nice pink on the inside. I give this one a solid B plus, maybe an A minus if the bun is a little better, but this is nice. And here we got the shrimp po' boy in my face. I'm just going to steal a little piece of the fried shrimp. I think I actually like hers better than mine. That is fire. I've actually never even had a shrimp po' boy back at home, but that is something nice and tasty. Good crisp on the shrimp, a little bit of spicy sauce on there. This is some fire food. Now it's time to dig in and eat.
Well, we just got done at the filling station. As I could say, it is a very typical American restaurant in that we got massive portions. We had to bring a little doggy bag to go. But now, to end the night off, we're going to one of May's favorite spots, which is just nearby, called Wantusawa, which is a famous oyster spot here in Poblacion. So, I guess I'm trying oysters for the first time tonight. Let's go. oysters have arrived. I'm kind of excited, kind of petrified. They look really weird and slimy. I really don't think these are going to taste good, but we're going to give it an honest shot here. We're going to see how these oysters are. We're going for round one. We got the oyster. This is what it looks like. It looks absolutely disgusting, to be honest. We got the calamansi, little fruit here in Asia. Gotta knock off those seeds. A little bit of vinegar.
That's a lot.
All right, I guess I put a lot of everything on. And then you just suck this thing.
Ugh.
I don't know how I feel about this. It's not bad, but it kind of just tastes like I ate a bunch of ocean water with limes in it. Not a fan. Next up, we got the baked, I was gonna say scallop, but this is an oyster. We got the baked oyster here. We're gonna try this one out. A lot better. I like those a lot. That first one, ugh, not so good. This, that is good. I like this one a lot. I would definitely order these again. The fresh live ones, not so much.
We just got done at Wansusawa. The oysters, the live ones, absolutely sucked. I will never eat another live oyster again in my life. But the baked ones were very good. The only thing was, is it was a bit loud. So we ended up leaving, but we still want to try that Barrick drink. So we are finding a bar here to get a nightcap of Barrick before we head home there for the night.
Hey. Hi, sir.
Hello.
You can drink upstairs.
What is this? This is what we are getting. We are getting the Barrick Lambanog. I don't exactly know what it is, but we're drinking it tonight.
All right, guys, it has arrived. And as you can see, this thing looks like death. It's like some secret juice in a bottle with a little skull on it.
Cheers. Good.
Like it?
I don't know why they have a skull on there, because that's actually pretty smooth. Very fruity, actually. And I'm not a liquor guy, but this is why I have her around here. She's got the best drink choices in all the Philippines. All right, y'all, we just got done at the Tambay Ali trying the Barrick, which was a very fruity liquor home here of the Philippines, which was absolutely amazing. Guys, if you have made it this far, thank you so much for watching. This has been a very fun night exploring Makati here. There's going to be plenty of more content coming here from the Philippines. Please like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.